Hello. Welcome to Grace Children's Sermon for March 14th. I'm Pastor Rachel, and I'm so glad that you're here. I'm doing the children's sermon from my house today because I want to show you some of my miniatures, and I keep them here at my house, like this teeny tiny cat. It's a little miniature cat, and it's made out of stone. And I also have these teeny tiny people. Look at them. They're so small. They're like the size of the top of my finger. But even though they're miniature and so small, they still have little eyes and little mouths. How neat. I also love just any kinds of miniature toys. They're so much fun to play with. You can put them in funny places to surprise people, like in a cabinet for when they open the cabinet. That's fun. I also like miniatures that you can build yourself, like these little Lego trains. I got to do a fun activity of building Lego trains, and now I have a miniature Lego train set. I wonder if you have a miniature Lego train. They're usually pretty fun to build. Yeah. I also think miniatures are really cool when they have a lot of details. Something surprising, maybe. Like this little pelican. He is also a Lego. But, you know, he's got his little wings. But what's really cool, look back here. This piece has little feather Legos. How cool is that? And if you open his little pelican mouth, there's a miniature fish in there because pelicans swoop down to the water and scoop up fish to eat. How cool is that? I also have this great little miniature that has a lot of detail. You know who this is? This is Martin Luther. And he has a little book that he has written, and it's in German because Martin Luther spoke and wrote in German. He also has this little quill pen for his writing. He also has, look, even the little tiny hat that he would have worn. Pretty cool. Now, if this Martin Luther was life-size, as big as me, we would probably see even more details, right? Like maybe we'd see the buttons on his clothes or the buckles on his shoes. But little teeny tiny Martin Luther has just enough detail that we know who he is. And we know this is Martin Luther. I think one of my favorite things about miniatures is that they can fit in your pocket. And so, you know, if you have somewhere to go, maybe you tuck one or two miniatures in your pocket, and wherever you go, you have a little bit of joy in your pocket. It's a lot of fun. Now, I also like miniatures because they remind me of today's gospel lesson. Why do you think that is? Well, it's a little bit because of Martin Luther. Our gospel lesson today is from the book of John. And one of the verses that we will hear in that passage is John 3:16. And that verse goes like this. For God so loved the world that God gave God's only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Now, Martin Luther, he called this verse the Bible in miniature. He meant if you look at the whole Bible, if you take everything that the Bible teaches us and you shrink it way down just to the most very basic thing, you would have this message that God loves us so much that God sent Jesus, God's only Son, to save us. Wow. It's amazing that the whole Bible can shrink down into that one sentence. I mean, look at this Bible. Look at this. There are so many words in here. And all of those words are really important. That's why we read from the Bible every Sunday. But Martin Luther is telling us that if we ever wonder what the gospel, the good news from God, if we're ever wondering what that's really about, we can read this verse. John 3:16, and know that God loves us so much that God sent Jesus to save us. We can tuck that good news into our hearts, just like we can tuck a miniature into our pocket, and we can carry that good news around with joy. I wonder who you could share this good news with today. I'm sure someone in your life would love to hear how much God loves them. I hope you'll share this good news in miniature. Let's end our time together with a prayer. I'll start and you repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for loving us. Thank you for sending Jesus to save us. Help us to believe in this good news. And help us share the good news with others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks for being here with me today. I hope you tuck this good news into your heart and then you share it with somebody, that God loves us so much and that Jesus came to save us. And I hope you have a great week and we'll see you again soon. Bye for now.